gorgeous out there. We've got mist hanging in the back. Oh, I don't think I'll be able to show you. And I'm running late, so I can't stop. Oh, I'm running late because I got a text message as I left the house confirming that Maggie is going to go and see Mrs. Magic Hands on Monday. Oh, by the way, good morning and welcome to Vlogmas Day 16. It is a beautiful morning. The sun is just rising and it's one of those, it's a clear night. There's a lot of moisture in the air, which means we get this lovely low-lying mist and it seems to hang above the field. So yes, I am running late, and then just to make matters more interesting, as I came to the bottom of my drive, who should be running down the road but Melanie. Now, I had to stop. It would have been rude not to, wouldn't it? It's your really good, one of your really good friends, with Lexi, who wanted to say hello. And I stopped and I thought, I'm going to have to go because this is just not fair. I can't talk to Melanie. And I just said, I'm really sorry I'm late, looking at the clock thinking 16 minutes past 8, it's lucky if I'm going to get there. But I'm not going to get to school for 8:30. I am definitely going to be late, but I don't honestly think anybody will mind today. It's just one of those days, and I know for a fact that when I get in there, well, the first thing Laura will say is, get yourself settled, have a cup of tea. It's the end of term, there's not much to do. There's always something to do in a school. Oh my god, the sun is just rising. There's nothing behind me, look at that. Can you see the sun? Is that not just the most beautiful, beautiful sight? Oh my god, that is gorgeous. That's made my morning.
The wonders of life got the prettiest side for everyone to enjoy. Standing up close by the Christmas tree, glimmering light, I am right where I wanna be. I will be home for a couple of days, wander around with you. You and me in the cold, thought it'd never be true. Wherever I go, I got you. Oh, I have stopped running, there is no way trying. You better loosen your belt. Drinking hot wine by the fire, don't care of anything else. It's Christmas and some kind of love, my friend. I pray it will never end. Do you like to be here too? It's Christmas and outside snow's glistening. It's just you and me tonight. I'll spend all this Christmas with you. Oh, it's such a charm, got you up in my arm. There's nobody at the door. You said I wish this will never be over. Darling, it's time for your present. Come over here.
Right, Jean is here, and we are going to have a little bit of fun. We're going to put up the bunting.
Jean is a little reluctant about this. She's wondering what she's getting roped in for.
She's not. Jean's just going to talk to me and have tea. So this is last year's bunting that I made. This was the bunting tree. I must be obsessed with trees.
Absolutely.
Oh, I do like a good forest. I do like a good wood. Are you want to see? You're laughing at me!
Oh no.
I am now going to climb on the work surfaces. I have a reputation I have to live up to. I thought if I put that in there,
Right, okay.
Let me see. It's alright, we can edit her.
Is it though? You haven't a bark? She doesn't like me standing up, she thinks I'm going to do something with that. I'll go and leave.
Oh.
Is it pulling out?
I don't think so.
Oh, okay. Oh my god.
Are you in your spare?
Hmm?
Are you just staring at me?
No. I just don't want you to ruin your cups.
I don't get those anymore. Those are Waitrose cups.
Oh, is Waitrose closed?
No.
Oh.
We haven't done them for a while.
Alright.
Okay.
that you might have to put your knee in the sink.
No.
Not quite.
No.
No. I'm going to sit down a bit out of the way. They look very nice, actually. Very, very nice.
It's what I'm going to attach it to.
You need a bit of blue tack.
Blue tack? You must be joking.
Okay.
Hold on. Hold on. It's going to be very blue, Peter. But it's definitely not one I made earlier.
Double bike sticky tape?
Double bike sticky tape. Sticky back plastic?
Sticky back plastic, that's what I meant. Double bike sticky tape. That's a gene, that is.
That's a gene. Sorry?
That's a genism.
A gene is what?
Double bike
sticky tape.
Meaning, I meant what you said.
Right, I'm over here now. We are. What I'd like to do is to have a nice long line. So what? We're joking for those of you that are watching from other parts of the world. We used a children's television program called Blue Peter, and the catchphrase was, "Here's one I prepared earlier." And I wish to goodness I did have one I prepared earlier, because now I can see where I want to put this to attach it. I've got.
Attach it to your bookshelf holder.
Oh, no, I don't want to attach it to the bookshelf holder, and I certainly don't want to take the camera there because I can see the cobwebs.
Well, everybody has.
I'd rather be sewing than cleaning cobwebs. Well, here goes.
You know what I need? I need a lamp like yours.
What? My ring light?
Yeah.
Oh, it's great, isn't it?
It's wonderful. I can't see enough, good enough sometimes when I'm sewing. But anyway, I just have to make that right before I do the
second. Right.
I put the zip in today for the first time I've done a zip for years.
Really?
Mm.
Was it a concealed zip?
Yeah.
With a single flap?
No, double flap.
So semi-concealed?
Yeah, I could have done it with a single. I should have done, actually. Yeah.
What we need to, Jean, is get you doing an invisible zip. Right, are we ready?
I have to come for lessons. Invisible zip.
Invisible zip. That's where the teeth
oh,
go
that's
on.
Oh, what I bought.
And you put it in as a
ordinary one, yeah. How do you put them in?
Here's Jean. Say hello, Jean.
Hello.
Now, there we go. There are the flag of. I actually quite like them there.
They're very nice.
Actually, do you know what I think I need to do for Christmas?
Take that one down. Remember.
I could actually get a little bit of invisible, like, fishing wire and put it between the two. That would hold it, wouldn't it? But I think it's okay.
Mind you,
like that, you can actually see it really well.
Yeah. Don't forget where you're putting your pictures. You forget it's there.
Well, who's going to... I've put them in my larder cupboard. So I'm not going to forget them, because every time I go to get a tea bag, here they are.
I hope I've got a larder cupboard.
Larder cupboard. Like this larder cupboard. And the tea bags are on this one. So I will not spot, I will not forget them.
No.
But I'm actually, isn't that lovely? That's Vlogmas 2020 up there. Shall we go over and have a little look? So, I can't even remember which end I started at. I'd have to go back to the actual vlogs and go through them all. I'm going out while Jean. Come back in behind Jean. Oh, I just love it. Do you know, I think Oh Come Let Us Adore Him might have been number 24. I do know, I can't remember which was my favourite. I really can't. I've got some great ideas. Anyhow, let's get on with today's tree. And I was just talking to Jean about...
I like that one.
Which one?
That one there.
This one?
No, that one. I think that's gorgeous. That's really pretty.
Yeah, and I'm not going to miss these, because every time I come into the kitchen, they're going to be there.
Yeah.
And it's such a big wall, I think it sort of fills it up.
So is that tape that you've got, is that same tape that you've just used?
Yes, it is.
All right. How long have you got some there?
because I put a great big reel of it on Amazon. Right, so before we start today's tree, here it is. It's a small one, similar size to the bobbin tree. Jean and I are laughing in the background here because...
This is third time lucky.
The first time I looked as if I'd got a Facebook mouth in it. No, looked like I had a TikTok mouth in it. It was absolutely hilarious. And then the second time I forgot to press record. So I'm going to do diagonal strips down this. And in order to give it the glitz and glam, this time it's going to have some embroidery thread on it, some machine embroidery thread. And I'm going to use these. I've got a gold, metallic red, and just an ordinary glossy one. And I'm just about to put the bobbin fill in. And all being well, this should not take long to do. Oh, why didn't I think of this earlier? I can use it as a display because the camera should focus in on it. Can we see? Oh, I absolutely love that. Now, how simple was today's tree? And I've left a little bit of gold thread to catch it up with. Now, I'm going to admit, I had a little tiny incident at the top here, and I did take out some stitching. I found something that would look quite like a nice little star. Do you know, I absolutely love that. That is so simple. So simple. I really love it. And I've tried something new on my sewing machine. I've sewn a metallic thread as if I was doing machine embroidery. I've put the bobbin fill bobbin in the bottom. I've got the right needle. I've got everything threaded properly and it's sewn those decorative stitches beautifully. So before I go and edit, I'm just going to make a couple of masks for tomorrow for school. And I might just bung you on time lapse for that one. Here we are back at the tree. Here's today's little tree. Now she's sitting on the tree next to a light. So let me just move the light out of the way so that it doesn't come back. Apologies for the camera shake, I'm not very steady. There we go. I think that's really effective. And the idea was to try and do an embroidered version of that. And I think I might have another go and do something else. Really like that. I do like that one as well. I was thinking of trying to do that one using, but folding it slightly differently. Maybe I might try that tomorrow. But I think I like the triangle shapes more than this shape. So as I end today's sat by the tree, the new tree is just a bit further up. I'm going to say good night to you all. I hope you've enjoyed today's vlog. It's been a bit, you know, random, I think. And I think sometimes that's what days are like. And I didn't think Jean was coming tonight and she rang up and said, could she pop over? And she's been such the most amazing friend to me over the years. I mean, I've known Jean a very long time. I'm trying to think how long we have known Jean now. Hannah was born in 92. I think we met Jean in 1994 the first time. And since then, she's been a really good family friend. And she lost her husband when her sons were 2 and 4. So in a way, she does understand the widowhood aspect and she's been such a massive, massive help. So when she wants to come over, I don't want to say no. And as you heard her say, she's 77 in January. She doesn't act like a 77-year-old, believe me. Absolutely no, I offered to carry a chair, got told off. I'm not that old yet. So on that note, I'm going to say good night. I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen. If you do, give me a thumbs up and a like. If you're new, welcome aboard and give me a subscribe and join me on this crazy journey. I don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. I think I'm going to Rachel's. and might see Bronte, which would be lovely. But it's the last day of term, so for now, good night, see you tomorrow.